This is Amelia Brunskill, and I'm going to be talking about using this worksheet with Excel formulas for systematic searching. This is what the spreadsheet looks like. We're on the first, has some notes on it about sort of an overview of how this works, important user notes, some warnings, and information about contacting me. The tableau that first includes a PubMed example, and then there are tabs for different databases, including PubMed, Medline, on the Ovid platform, Embase on Elsevier, CINAHL on EBSCO, and PsycINFO on ProQuest. I'm going to go into the PubMed tab. I'm going to talk through how it's designed a little bit, and then I'm going to show an example. So how this works is basically we have things separated into three concepts in columns, and then for each of those, there's separate areas for the mesh, in this case mesh headings, or otherwise controlled vocabulary terms at the top, and then keywords at the bottom. And there's places for you where you can paste the terms that you have for mesh, and then keywords for each of your concepts. Each of these, you'll see if I click on this, there's an embedded formula. So what this happens is if you put a term here, it takes that term, and then it concatenates. That's so that you get a quotation mark, the term itself, another quotation mark, and then you get mesh in brackets to give you a formatted term that will be searched for as a mesh term. Whereas in the keywords down here, the term you put in here will get concatenated. So again, the quotation marks put around the term, but then here we are searching in the title and abstract field. That's fairly commonly used in PubMed. Sometimes people choose to use TW or text word instead. So we have that for each of those concepts. And what happens is, so when you put something in there, it gets formatted then, and then you paste it as values here. And then on the right, we have a series of formulas that basically take what you've put in there and add additional formatting. I think, though, the easiest way to understand and explain what happens there is to do an example. So here I have, on another screen, I have collected for each of my three concepts, which here are ADHD, children, and physical activity. I have collected mesh headings and keywords for each of those concepts. So for this first one, we're going to take attention deficit disorder and hyperactivity. That's a mesh heading that we found. And I'm going to paste that here. And you'll see that immediately the formula adds in that correct formatting. Then I'm going to paste the keywords. And these, I scroll down and I put them in the empty spaces here. Okay, so here we have this formula of terms, but at the moment it still has that formula attached. So what we want to do is we want to have the values only. So what we do is we are going to copy and then we're going to paste, but then we're going to say we don't want it copied as a formula, we want just the values. So there it changes, and it's now, when we click on this field, we'll see just the text that we want. It's no longer in a formula. So now we're going to go down, do the same thing here, grab all of this at once, paste, and then as values. So if we scroll, what we see here is this formula with a text join is it's taking all of those terms and it's oring them together. So, because what this formula does is it separates with or, so separates with what you've put in here, all of them. True means that it ignores any empty spaces and just goes down from C6 to C204, which would be a lot of terms. We'll see that this is the C6, so it basically starts there and finds any values that have been added in here, and it just ors them together into a string for that concept. So what we'll do now is we'll just continue with concept 2, again, pasting those in here. And then paste as values. Paste as values. One more time for that third concept. So now we'll see that basically there's a formula for each of those concepts. And then there's a formula here that takes the strings from up here. And what it does is it takes them, so N2, N4, and N6, takes the content in there. It puts parentheses around them. So we're adding in parentheses around each of them. And also putting and between those. So you have that here. And the easiest way to do, and again, this is still formulas, so we'll want to do one last copy as values only. So paste and then values. And so now we have this nice big string. If we wanted to see it more clearly, I'll just paste it here and do a quick merge and center wrap. So you can see we have this nice long string. We have the attention deficit terms all put together in parentheses, and then we have and then we have all the children terms, and then we have again and all the exercise terms put together. So we have a nice search string that we can use for testing for a systematic search. So the other databases, basically different databases have slightly different formatting, so just included that in the formulas. They'll just look a little bit different, but everything else sort of works roughly the same. It just makes a big search string that then you can use. So we have Medline, Embase, CINAHL, and PsycINFO. So that's basically how this spreadsheet works. All right, so I hope this will be helpful, and please feel free to contact me if you have any questions.